Hi everyone, today I'm going to be doing something slightly different. Over the course of the next couple of weeks, I'm going to be sharing some quick tutorials with you so that I can showcase some of Canva's brand new features. Canva has just given us the green light to share them with you, so you'll be one of the first to test them out. So today I'm going to be showing you how to create some even more eye-catching and professional presentations in Canva using Canva's new slide transitions. I'll also be sharing with you one of my own Nicky ninja tips using one of these new transitions. You don't need to have Canva Pro for this tutorial, but if you would like to take Canva Pro for a test ride and experience all the wonderful features you can get, just type this link into your browsers to get a free 45-day upgrade. This is an exclusive offer only available from Canva certified creatives, so I will leave the link in the description box below so you can check it out later. Right, so if you're ready, let's go over to Canva. As you can see, I've already loaded up a beautiful presentation onto my Canva desktop. If you don't know how to search for a suitable presentation template in Canva, why not watch this particular tutorial here? It'll tell you everything you need to know about using Canva presentation templates. I'll leave a link in the end screen and in the description box below. So I've loaded up just a couple of pages from this presentation. That's all I need in order to show you how to add transitions. You'll need to view your slides with thumbnail images underneath. If you're still scrolling down to view your pages, all you need to do to change the view is click on this little tiny arrow at the bottom of your screen, and that will bring up the thumbnail image view. To view each individual page, all you need to do is hover your mouse over the thumbnail image and click on it. Before I dive into the transitions, I think it's just worthwhile me pointing out a few tips and tricks that you can access from the thumbnail view. To add a fresh new page, hover your mouse in between two slides until you see this plus icon. Click it to add a new page. If you hover your cursor over the top right-hand corner of a thumbnail image, you'll see three little dots appear. Just click on them once, and you'll see a menu of actions that you can take. At the top, you can add a page. Beneath that, you can duplicate a page. So that means making an exact copy of that particular page. You can add a transition. You can delete a page, and you can also add notes to a page. And these will be your presenter notes. And they appear on the left-hand side of your screen. Now let me show you how to add your transitions. So let's say, for instance, I want to add a transition between this page and this page. So I'm going to click on the three little dots again and click on Add Transition. You'll see that a new transition menu appears on the left-hand side of your screen. Hover your cursor over each transition to see the effect it has on a page. If I click on the dissolve transition, you'll see that underneath there is a slider bar with a little button on it. Each transition has this particular slider bar. Use it to alter the transition duration in seconds. So I've selected the dissolve transition for this particular page, and I'm going to make it last for 2 seconds. Let me just quickly run through the other transitions. In the top right, you have slide. Again, you can alter the timing of the duration using the slider bar here or the little box. Underneath that, you have 4 arrows, and you can use these to change the direction of the transition. So right to left, left to right, up or down. And the circle wipe, again, you can alter the duration in seconds. And you can also alter the direction that the transition will appear, so in or out. Lastly, the line wipe is very similar to the slide transition, only a little bit more subtle. And let's not forget this little power tool right at the bottom here. If you'd like the same transition to apply to all your pages in your slideshow, just click on the button Apply Between All Pages, and that's going to save you an awful lot of time. I'm going to go ahead and add some transitions to the rest of my pages. Once you've set your transitions, you can easily test them out to see what they look like, just to make sure they work smoothly. So I'm going to go to the start of my presentation, and then I'm going to go to the top right-hand corner of my Canva desktop and click on the Present button. I'm going to make sure that the type is set to Standard, and then click on Present. And here you'll go straight into a full screen mode. And now if I click on the edge of my screen, I can transition from page to page. And I think those transitions work perfectly. Don't forget that if you want a colleague's input or opinion about your presentation, all you need to do is click on the Copy link and send the link by email. And now for one of my little Nicky ninja tips. If you're familiar with PowerPoint, you might know about the zoom animation. This allows you to seamlessly zoom in on a section of your slide. I'm now going to show you how to create exactly the same effect in Canva using one of our new transitions. Imagine that you're presenting your beautiful beach holiday slides to an audience and you want to zoom in on this photograph. So here's what you do. Go down to the thumbnail, click on the three little dots, select Duplicate to create an exact copy of the page. Since I want to zoom in on the photograph, I'm just going to delete this text. I'm now going to run my cursor over the sections I want to zoom in on to select them. And you can see the sections that I've selected because they're surrounded by a dotted blue line. If it helps you, you can go to the Group button right at the top right-hand corner of your toolbar and click on it. Now grab a hold of these corner buttons with your cursor to increase the size of your grouped elements. Go back to the original slide, select Transition, select Dissolve, and you'll want to set the duration to about 2 seconds. I'm going to test this out now by clicking on the first slide, going up and clicking on the Present button, making sure that it's in standard mode, clicking on Present. And that is absolutely perfect. Canva has zoomed in, or seemingly zoomed in, absolutely seamlessly on that beautiful photograph. I think it's a great trick, don't you? So what do you think? If you enjoyed the transitions, give me a thumbs up so I can give Canva some feedback. As I mentioned at the start of this video, I'm going to be creating some quick tutorials over the next couple of weeks, so make sure you subscribe to my channel, otherwise you're going to miss out. If you want to learn more about Canva presentation templates and how to search for them in Canva, check out my video right here. Otherwise, feel free to check out my playlist of Canva presentation videos, which is right here. Thank you so much for watching and for all your support, and I will see you next time.